Welcome to IGM Guru. IGM Guru is one of the global leading online training and certification provider for IT expert by the skilled IT gurus to help them achieve their professional goals.
Guys, welcome to the robotics world. So today we are going to see how RPA and what are the things related with RPA. So before starting, let me introduce myself. My name is Siddharth. I have total 8 plus years of experience in development, especially in RPA. So I worked on intelligence process automation, IPA, RPA, machine learning, AI, as well as data science. So I was working as a developer and then I moved to the RPA. Since 2016, I'm working in RPA industry. Along with that, I also conduct online and offline training. More than 500 professional I have trained so far. 30 plus corporate training I have done. Along with this, I also provide consultation related with the RPA and a project development. So I own my organization, which is RPA7, and also I worked as a freelancer trainer. So this is all about myself. It's introduction. I have all the certification from the UiPath as well as from the Blue Prism. I'm AWS and SAFe certified, and also I've worked on Amazon AWS. So this is all about myself. So let's discuss about yourself. Of course, right now we don't have anyone, so just I'll skip this part. Okay, so before moving to RPA or robotics process automation, we need to understand first what is process automation. So what is process automation? So basically, process automation is nothing but the tools which you are working on daily basis. You or your organization or your other colleagues may work on, are working on this particular tool, especially SAP, mainframe, CRM. These are the widely used process automation tools available in the market. Okay, so why we call this as a process automation? Because when we provide some input data, it gives us some output in the report, or maybe it's just a data storage where we can get all the details. For example, if I'm going for a SAP, in SAP success factor, I can insert employees record, all the related activities of employees can get will get stored in the SAP. So this is a tool. These are the tools which worked on purely paperless work. So you don't need to create Excel sheet to maintain the data. You don't need to create a reports, or you don't need to create files or something. Mainframe is the same thing, where you can connect with the data. You will get the details. CRM, where we have a customer data, vendors data. So these all are process automation tools. So what are the gaps to the process automation? So there, when I say gaps, it does it nothing with the tools. It's nothing with the whether they have limited access or not. It just a gaps while working on it. For example, in SAP, it is very high cost. It has a compliance issue. Human workforce is required more. Whereas in mainframe, there is a complex legacy system. Hence, I require a professional who knows everything about the mainframe. And in CRM, there is a lot of data entry. Hence, the quality may get impact. So this is process automation. These all tools are related with the process automation. So process automation, earlier it was there. Then what the RPA? So only process automation, before process automation, one word is added, and that is called the robotics. Okay, now this robotics, which here we have, is nothing but a robots can work on your process automation tool instead of a human. Hence, RPA not replacing the target application or target process automation tools like mainframe, CRM, Salesforce. It just replaced the human who is working on it. So hence it is called robotics process automation. Means when I talk about the definition, what is robotics process automation does, so simply we need to understand one more thing. So let me go to the second slide. So robotics process automation is nothing but RPA bot or robo or robot. We call it as a bot, robo or robot. So what is the definition of RPA? So basically robotics process automation is nothing but which a robot or software robot works on your process automation tool to mimic the human behavior, to mimic the daily task, rule-based daily task or monthly task, whatever you are doing, not only on these three process automation tool, but any of the application, for example, SAP, PDF, mainframe, Salesforce, CRM, your web applications, Windows applications, databases. So basically RPA mimics the human behavior. It works on rule-based tasks, and this is a simple and sweet example. So we are not replacing the application, we are replacing the human. Okay. Now, when we talk about robots or software robots, as I told you, we called it as a bot in term of RPA. So there are two types. One is your back office robot, which works independently. You don't need to provide anything. It works. You have to define once and it works automatically. Whereas front office robot, which works, which will not work independently, but it works with the user. So it asks you some inputs while processing some data, and then you need to provide as an input, and rest of the thing will get take care of the bot. So where we use this back office and front office robot? So we need to understand the use cases first. So whenever there are a rule-based repetitive task in my organization, for example, if I'm talking about an insurance domain, so every day I need to claim a particular insurance, whether it's a payout disease, whether it's accidental, whether it's a pension plan. There are a lot of applications where I need to put, where I need to provide the data, and I get some output. So this is something I work behind the scene background. I don't require a front office robot. So hence I can have a back office robot to do this thing. Whereas in front office robot, if I'm going for a IT help desk or L1 help desk, where the user assigns a request or tickets, and your bot will process it, and if that particular ticket gets resolved, it asks you whether this ticket resolved or not. If it is resolved, then it will move on the next level. If it is not resolved, it will highlight to the L2. So this is kind of a front office robot. In between the process, human or a man who is working on it needs to provide input, and that is called a front office robot. Now, when we talk about this robot and when we talk about this RPA, we need to understand another one concept, that we create a process in one tool, whether it's a Blue Prism or UiPath or automation anyway. There are a lot of tools available in the market. So these tool, these processes where we create in a particular tool. For example, this is one example of process. Log in to Gmail or Outlook, download the attachment from the mail, store that attachment, read data one by one, and then insert that record into the SAP. This is a one process rule-based task which I do every day. Okay, so I don't require a person who is working on it. I will create a process and then I will execute it or I will run it. So runtime resource in Blue Prism, it is called runtime resource, because when you create a process, you require a machine, maybe your personal machine, maybe it's a virtual machine or desktop, whatever. When you run this, then I can say my bot is working. Then I can say my bot is running. So combination of process plus bot machine or your executor is nothing but your bot, your actual bot. So this is a actual example, actual definition of robo, bot or robot. Okay. Now, if I go further and if I give the detailed characteristics characteristics of RPA. So there are various characters and benefits of RPA. Why all the companies are moving to RPA? Why every organization is planning to have the different tools to deal with this thing? So every insurance, every BFS, every telecom, every healthcare domain is now using the RPA tools. Of course, they are using different tools. So it works on the presentation layer. No coding at all required. You can create app using this particular tool. Benefits, if I talk about the benefits, there is a low manpower cost, future proof, of course 100%, it will not provide you any error or exception, improves the productivity, and the most important part, it does not eat, sleep, not get bored, and it carry the business faster. It works 24/7, and hence these are all characteristics and benefits, hence every organization is moving into the RPA world. Now if I talk about this matrix, so average processing time for a record, when I say record, it may be your customer record you need to add in a Salesforce, or it may be invoice record where you need to add in a SAP, it may be your employee records you will need to add in a SAP success factor. So if I go for manually, it takes 3 minutes, but using RPA what I can do it within a 15 seconds, 90% I can reduce the time. Average waiting time, it will reduce to 0 days, because I don't need to wait, or there will no any dependency on human. And of course the quality does matter, so quality will be 100%. And here is a impact of RPA. We need to understand the impact. These all are definition of RPA, how it works, what is the process, what is the executor or runtime, resource or bot machine. So if there are three different types of applications and three different type of people is working on it, because each people have, you know, that particular domain knowledge. If I replace all these three people, one software bot, yes, I can replace. So my software robot or bot can work on three different applications. And that is the reason there is a huge impact. So if you heard about the Cognizant layoff, Infosys layoff, yes, it is because of RPA, robotics process automation. And this is again a research. Because of RPA, there are in HFS research saying IT sector will lose 6.4 lakh low skill job. So when I say low skill job, it doesn't mean that, you know, all jobs will get replaced, but yes. So when I say low skill, what are those? So your claim representative, your financial advisor, your maybe a KPO guy, BPO guy who is just processing the records, your HR who is you doing your onboarding process and everything. So these are, I'm not saying these are the low skill job, but these are the perfect RPA candidates where we can automate such kind of process. So I don't require HR, I don't require, you know, other KPO, BPO guy, because I can create a robot. And this is again a research which is provided by, you know, various Gartner saying it will trim 1.4 million global service by 2020. This is all our facts. You can Google it, you will get it. But this is a one site, this is a one story, but what is the next? So before moving the next, we need to understand these are the industry which is on high risk. So when I say high risk, yes, there might be a job loss in healthcare, e-commerce, BPO, KPO, insurance, BFSI, HR, especially testing, because manual tester I don't require, I can have a bot who can test it. Okay, so these are the role which are highly on high risk: financial analyst, tax driver, investor manager, tester, software professional, journalist. So all their work I can automate easily, so I don't require the people who is working for the same. So why should I hire such kind of people where I need to provide the infrastructure, where I need to provide the salaries, leaves and everything, and my productivity will be 6 hours for a person. So that is the reason. This is the one side. Another side is if there are job losing, at the same time there are some hopes, there are some jobs which will get created by RPA. So these are the new skill, these are the new technology currently booming in industry. We have RPA, AI, machine learning, IoT. So we need to reskill and upskill if we want to survive in IT industry. And this happens every time. Okay. So why RPA? Because RPA can work on each type of applications, databases, your files, whether it's a PDF, XML, text, Word, PNG, and all type of databases. And that is the reason we have a lot of opportunities in RPA. Especially if you see, and this is something I'm not saying, you can Google, you will get every day, you will get more than, you know, 100 plus jobs opening in RPA. So we have a, you know, if it, this is RPA market size projected to reach $8.75 billion by 2024. So these all are facts. You need to understand the, what are the, how I can go, how can I grab this opportunity in terms of RPA. Okay. So now when we talk about this RPA, so there are a lot of opportunities while profile wise. I can have a, I required a BA, I required a developer, I required a tester, RPA tester, I required RPA manager, RPA TL, I required RPA controller. So these are profiles which are available in the market, because if I'm saying I will automate all the process, at the same time I required a RPA developer who will create it. At the same time I required RPA tester who will test it, RPA BI required. So these are all are opportunities we have in this market. Now, as I was saying that these are the use cases where we can go for RPA processes. Okay. So in HR onboarding process, I told you, right? So when you onboard, you will get, you know, a lot of documentation you need to provide, you need to fill all those records, all those information that will get circulated to your admin department, payroll department, PF department. Who does this? So some behind the scene, there is someone who is working on it, maybe your HR or HR assistant. But why should I hire a HR or HR assistant when I have a bot? Similarly, in insurance, new business automation application processing, in financial credit card application processing and everything. So these are a few use cases which I have mentioned here. Now, if you talk about the tools, there are a lot of tools available in the market. So which can work. So which gives you the lot of advantages, lot of features. For example, Blue Prism, UiPath, OpenSpan, WorkFusion, Automation Anywhere. These all are tools available in the market, but yes, the current and leading is Blue Prism, and then UiPath, and then Automation Anywhere. Of course, there are a lot of differences between these three, but these are the leading in the market. If I talk about the Blue Prism, this is the most stable RPA tool in the world. So, and Automation Anywhere is the least stable tool, whereas UiPath is moderate. So there are some parameters are there where we can, you know, compare these three tools. So this is a just industry-wise distribution. So these are the Blue Prism, which is a core RPA capability. We have a Pega, which is related with the BPM. Now they have converted into the RPA. So Pega now can have a RPA tool in that. So how we can start to learn the RPA? Just you need to create a small, you know, process, then complex, and then more complex processes. What are the prerequisites are required to learn it? So you don't require any programming knowledge. If you have, that is added advantage. You should understand the flow diagram, UML diagram, how it works, and you should have the understanding of a business process, insurance domain or healthcare or manufacturing or your telecom, whatever. Who can learn the RPA? Anyone who wants a white collar job, especially a tester, because as I told you, manual automation, manual testing will not be there after 6 or 1 year down the line. Trust me, that is a fact, because I can do the same thing with the help of bot. I'm not saying all 10 testers get replaced with the bot, but yes, 80%, 8 testers will get replaced with the bot. And this is all about the what is RPA, how it works, how RPA works. So now this is the Blue Prism, because we are sure we are seeing the Blue Prism. Blue Prism, as I told you, is most stable tool in the market, and we have to install only one setup for the Blue Prism. Control room is inbuilt in that. What is control room? Well, it is just manage your robots, bots, which process you want to run on which bot. That is all. So I have one small demo here. This is the process, how it looks. This is a diagram. Okay, this is all diagram you need to create as a RPA developer. Of course, every stages or every activity or command you are seeing here is has some specific work. So what I'm doing here, so there is an Excel file. Okay, I'm getting it from the email. Every day I'm getting an email which contains attachment. My bot will download it, and that Excel file one by one record it process to a web application. Web application gives me a reference number where bot will write back to the Excel, and that attachment will get processed. This is for a travel domain. So just see this. I'm running this process in the Blue Prism. So it opens the Excel file. This is a web application. Okay. This is a web application. This is an Excel file. It is logged in. It is launched. It is adding one by one record. And these records, if you see here, we got here. Okay, so this record, we got it. It's inserted from here. If you see, this is the United Kingdom. This is the name is Sydney. We got it here. So now, because it contains the old data, hence this is giving me the future date. But one by one record, it will get at here. And at the end, this will reference number will get inserted here. This way. So this is a small use case. Similarly, I can create a lot of processes which dealing with the target automation, like Notepad. For example, if I go here, so how can I create a process? So if you see, this is a home tab. There are five options available: Studio, Control Room, Analytics, Release, and System. Of course, every option has specific role, but most 95% work for RPA developer is in this Studio tab, where you can create a process, where you can create an object. So there are two entities here, process and object. What are these things? So this is, when we go in detail, we will understand. For now, if I want to connect with the Notepad, so I'll create one object, let's say Notepad, and I'll click on next. I will finish it. One object gets added. If I want to add a Notepad, if I want to automate a Notepad, how can I do that? So you just need to go to the application modeler. You need to provide which type of application is you are using, and then you need to provide that exe. I'm showing in fast mode because I'm just giving one demo. So it is a Windows System 32. I'm just giving the notepad.exe. This is my notepad.exe I have provided. Okay, if I launch this, it will get launched. I need to spy this, so I will spy this element and I will apply, click OK. So here you need to launch this application. You need to create a flow such that where you are launching, what are the things you want to do through the bot. So you need to train to the bot. How I am going to train this? Using this stages. These all are stages available in Blue Prism, where you can use it for this navigation is used to navigate, write stage is used to write, whatever you want to write, you can write in this particular area. So hi, this is Robo. And then you need to connect it. Start, launch, then write, and then end. So this is how it works. So let me refresh this, and if I run this, so it will launch the Notepad application and it will write this. So this is a small again demo for the Blue Notepad application which we have created in the Blue Prism. So Blue Prism is not freeware, but yes, right now it is available for 3 months trial version. You can download it, but only thing you require, your company or your official email ID which you have need to with the Blue Prism, otherwise you cannot download. But through our, we will provide you the tool, and also we will provide a license which is valid for 1 year. So you will get a license plus this tool which we will get installed on very first day. So this is all about RPA and Blue Prism. Now if we talk about the there are certain certifications available for this Blue Prism. You need to, so if I go, let me open this certification. This is a certification available for Blue Prism. No, so Blue Prism not provides any certification which is free of cost. There is a cost. What is certification? So basically when you go for a certification or when you have the certification, it means that you have knowledge of Blue Prism. Okay, so there are a lot of certifications. For example, AD01, which is a basic one, which is only this is a common one which is available or which needs to be done by any type of profile, whether you are developer, whether you are tester, whether you are manager, this has to be there. If it's not a mandatory, but if you have, it is an added advantage. Then we have installing and configuration. This is related with the, you know, installation engineer. We have APT01. If you want to go for a RP development, then the second certification you can go with APT01. We have ROM architect. We have ASD0 solution design. I do have this APT01, AD01, and ASD01. All these certification, because other certification I am not related with this, because I am a developer, so installing which is something I don't require at all. So every AD01, we will provide you the dumps, we will provide you the, so when you go for a training or anything sort of from this organization, AD01 you can easily crack, and we will provide you dumps. So for AD01 there is a $70, $70 is a fees, and this is a one time, it will not get refund. If you fail, you have to pay another. 60 questions, all are MCQ. Okay, 60 questions for 60 minutes, you'll get 1 minute for one question. And this is online exam where you need to go for a center, you need to choose the center, and when you allocated a particular timeline from that center, you need to go there with your 2 ID proof, and then you can go for this one. And once you done that, you immediately will get a result whether you pass or not. Okay, so this certification helps. We will provide not only certification, resume building, and along with that interview preparation and interview question and answer. So this is the all about the Blue Prism. There are two entities, as I told you, process and object. What are these things? Of course, we will discuss in detail. So I think I have done from my end. Thank you guys. Thank you so much for the joining. Thanks for your time.
Thanks for watching the video. For full course, please visit www.igmguru.com and enroll today.